We want to find the x and y intercepts of a circle that has a radius 5 and centered at the point -2, 3. Before we find the intercepts though, let's first find the equation of the circle, where if the equation of a circle is in this form here, h, k would be the center of the circle and r is the radius. So notice here h is equal to -2, k is equal to +3, and r is equal to +5. So the equation of the circle would be the quantity x minus -2 squared. We'll simplify this to +2 in just a moment, plus the quantity y minus 3 squared equals 5 squared. So now if we simplify this, we would have the quantity x plus 2 squared plus the quantity y minus 3 squared equals 25. So this is the equation we'll use to find the intercepts of the circle. Before we do this though, let's look at the graph of this circle. Here it is on the coordinate plane. So we're looking for these two x-intercepts and these two y-intercepts. Regardless of what the equation is or what the function is, to find the x-intercepts, we always set y equal to 0 and solve for x. And to find the y-intercepts, we always set x equal to 0 and solve for y. So taking this equation here and setting y equal to 0, that would give us the quantity x plus 2 squared plus, this would just be -3 squared, equals 25. Now we need to solve this for x. We could multiply the quantity x plus 2 squared out, but let's go ahead and leave this as squared. We'll isolate this and then solve the equation using square roots. So we'll leave this as the quantity x plus 2 squared, this would be +9, equals 25. And now we'll subtract 9 on both sides of the equation. That would give us the quantity x plus 2 squared equals 16. And again, now we'll undo the squaring by taking the square root of both sides of the equation. Remember, when we do this though, we need to make sure to remember to include a plus or minus sign here so that we get both solutions for x. Notice because we're squaring the left side, we could square a positive and square a negative to still get positive 16. So now we would have the square root of the quantity x plus 2 squared would just be x plus 2, and plus or minus the square root of 16 would be plus or minus 4. So we'll go ahead and subtract 2 on both sides, and we have x equals -2 plus or minus 4. So there are two values of x, or two x-intercepts, based upon our solution. One solution would be x sub 1 equals -2 plus 4, that's +2. And the other solution for x would be -2 minus 4, which would be -6. So we have two x-intercepts. One would have coordinates 2, 0, and the other would have coordinates -6, 0. So go back to the graph just for a moment. The graph does verify our work. Here's the x-intercept 2, 0, and here's the x-intercept -6, 0. Now let's find the two y-intercepts. These won't come out so nice. So we'll set x equal to 0 and solve for y. So if x is equal to 0, we would start with just 2 squared plus the quantity y minus 3 squared equals 25. Again, we're not going to multiply out the quantity y minus 3 squared. We'll use square roots again to solve for y. So 2 squared is 4. Subtracting 4 on both sides of the equation, we would have the quantity y minus 3 squared equals 21. And now to undo the squaring, we'll take the square root of both sides of the equation, include a plus or minus sign here on the right. So now we would have just one factor of y minus 3 equals plus or minus the square root of 21. So if we add 3 to both sides of the equation, we have y equals 3 plus or minus the square root of 21. The square root of 21 does not simplify, so the two solutions for y, or the two y-intercepts, would be y sub 1 equals 3 plus the square root of 21, and y sub 2 would be equal to 3 minus the square root of 21. So these would be the exact values of the y-intercepts, but let's also get decimal approximations. So 3 plus the square root of 21 is approximately, let's say, 7.58. And then if I press second enter, I can just change the plus sign to a minus sign. So the second y-intercept would be approximately negative 1.58. Which means our two y-intercepts would be 0, 3 plus square root 21 and 0, 3 minus square root 21. So we should not give the rounded values unless we're actually asked to round. So now if we go back to our graph, here's the larger y-intercept of 0, 3 plus square root 21. Or using the decimal approximation, we could say it's approximately 0, 7.58, which is easier to use to verify graphically. And then for the second y-intercept down here, we would have 0, 3 minus square root 21, or using the decimal approximation, it would be 0, negative 1.58, which does look correct. I hope you found this explanation helpful.